Today on Art Matters with Mr. Morris.
Value, lighting, and contrast.
Art Matters with Mr. Morris.
Yeah.
Welcome back, my artists. Today we're talking again about value, but this time we're talking about contrast.
But first, a disclaimer.
Now I do have to warn you right now, contrast is one of our
principles of design
that we're going to be covering with next week's lesson. I don't want you to get this confused with the principle of design. One way of thinking of it is we have different kinds of music. And if I was to say that rap music represented all music, that would be a lie. When I'm talking about contrast in this way that I am in today's video, I'm only talking about a small part of what contrast can be.
That was a disclaimer.
So as we already know, value requires both light and shadow. Without the light, I don't have value. Without the shadow, I don't have value. When we talk about value in terms of extreme levels of light and dark, what we're really talking about is contrast. Right now I've got this light bulb, and when I shine it near my face, it illuminates one side of my face, very bright in value, and the other side's very dark. I might say that in a scale of value 1 to 10, this would be a 1, versus over on this side of my face, it's going to be closer to a 10. By changing the position of light, I change the mood. At the beginning, I had the light facing straight up, and it gives that scary movie appearance. The reason why is because we're not used to seeing faces lit from underneath, and we're also kind of put off by deep shadows in faces. It makes them look more foreboding, more scary. We're used to the lighting coming down from above on top of people's heads, or from up above at a little bit of an angle. What's good about extreme lighting or high contrast is it polarizes value. It gives us value that is more extreme and less just those kind of middle gray tones. Value is one of the single most important of our elements of art, and I'm going to actually tell you, in my opinion, I think it is the most important, because the more you practice doing value and shading in your artwork, the more you start to lighten your line pressure, the more you start to make mistakes and not worry about them and just continue making the artwork. I think value is one of those things that it ties a piece of artwork together the most, and that's why from here on out, all of your artwork should be experimenting and trying different ways of depicting that value. We already know that value is affected by light, and we already know that contrast is created through extreme light and extreme shadow. We can also do this digitally, and let me show you what that looks like.
Here's a photograph I took for the Morris Mini Studio introduction. I did not focus on this being high contrast, but I can make it high contrast. So I've just opened it up on Preview, which is available on all Macs, but even if you have a PC computer, there's different programs you can use. In this case, I've gone to Tools, and I'm going to go down here to Adjust Color. Once I've done that, you can see I have this menu here. It's got Contrast, it's got Exposure, it's got Temperature, and most importantly, it's got Saturation. By turning my Saturation all the way down, I turn the photo into grayscale, or monochromatic, or just a black and white image. Now, right now, I've got a lot of grays that kind of fit in the middle of the scale. I've got a lot of like 3s to 7s. I don't have those extreme darks and those extreme lights. I can fix that, though, by adjusting my brightness up. I want to try to make it so that I have a clear, distinct area where I can see that whitest white. Now that I have my whitest white area made, now I can go over here to contrast. By increasing the contrast, I'm going to make the darks darker. And by decreasing it, I'm going to give it everything that grayscale again. Of course, I want to increase the contrast for our effect. The more I increase it, the more extreme it gets, until eventually it's just going to become a black and white only image, like what you see here. I don't want that, so I want to dial this back just a little bit until I have those 5 values. I really want to see 5 different levels of gray. On our first video on value, I showed you the pencil hardness chart. We're going to use that today. Our normal HB pencil can definitely hit this range from a 4H to a 4B very easily. So let's focus in on that 4H to a 4B. Now, all those numbers and letters are really in reference to pencil hardness, so let's change that so it's just a 1 to a 10. We have a value scale now that shows a value of 1 all the way up to 10, with 0 being pure white and 10 being as black as you can get your pencil to go. We talk about making artwork that shows the value tones much better. What we're really talking about is reducing down the number of variables we have in our lights and darks. In other words, we're removing a bunch of these numbers. What we'll do is we'll take the 5 most extreme or every other value, and that's what we're going to focus on. When you create an image that's high contrast, or you adjust the contrast on it to be higher, what you're really talking about doing is taking that grayscale of a 1 to 10 and you're turning it to a grayscale of a 1 to 5. You're making it so that it's more extreme and more harsh than if it had all of those gray tones. In doing this, it makes it easier as an artist to break down those gray tones into shapes and render the artwork more accurate to real life. But increasing the contrast in your artwork also makes it so that value shows form more accurately. It tends to show that rounded shape of an object more than when you have all of those gray tones represented. Chiaroscuro is an Italian term that essentially translates to light and dark. And for many, it's considered to be a benchmark of what the great masters did. In master's paintings, or even in modern movies, whenever you see an image like this one here, where you have light lights and very dark darks in opposition of each other, it means that the artist or the creator is using that concept of chiaroscuro. By turning the color off on this image, you can really see those 5 values, those 5 distinct levels of light and dark being represented, instead of having the wide spectrum of, say, 10 or 15 levels of gray. This method is mostly seen in art history for portraiture. However, it's also used for a lot of still life and for other arrangements as well. Artworks that utilize this idea, this concept, are artworks that represent value and high contrast.
I have taken just some random objects, put them together to create a still life. And right now, I have lighting and it's coming from several different directions at once so that everything is very well lit. So what I've done is I've just taken some random objects from the studio, piled them in a little pile, and I've made a little still life or something that is not alive that I've put together and arranged for copying for artwork to learn different skills. Right now, my light source is coming from 3 different spots. So I've got a light that's coming from up above, I've got a light that's coming from over here, and a light that's coming over here. I do this on my studio table so that there's no shadow and you can see what I'm doing. However, for getting a high contrast picture, this doesn't work that great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach up here. I'm going to turn off one of my light sources. Whoa, check that out. Already the shadows have really started to bounce in, and instead of having everything be kind of just those medium tone grays, now I'm getting some very dark darks. But I can enhance this even more by limiting my light sources even more. Not by much, but it definitely made it so that these areas are much darker. Now I can take an image and upload that image to a computer or an iPad, tweak the contrast or the brightness, and really enhance that look of the lightest lights and the darkest darks to really make this into 5 different values instead of quite as many as you're seeing here.
Today, we talked about how value depends on light. And we talked about how light is needed to show contrast.
We talked about how contrast polarizes value and makes it so it's more extreme and easier for our eye to see and separate the different levels of. We talked about how single direction of lighting like this creates these extreme differences in value.
And last, we talked about an Italian word,
chiaroscuro,
and how it is in most classical artwork, and again, helps to make our artwork more interesting and more captivating for our audience.
My artists, hopefully you can put into contrast why this is so important in your work, and you can truly value what you've learned. Hopefully it was very enlightening. Until next time, my artists, please remember, be kind to yourself and keep on making art. I'm Mr. Morris. Have a great day.